and needed some coins to build that dream team you guys have always wanted, make sure to head on over to my sponsor, BuyMaddenCoins. They have the cheapest, the quickest, and most reliable coins on the market right now. Head on over to BuyMaddenCoins and use code Poodle at checkout for 20% off your order. What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. Today we're going over what we should be doing before Series 5 comes out. Now, I've been getting a lot of questions. Now, as you guys know, a lot of my video ideas come from the comments, so it's always great when you guys ask questions. Now, if I just see one question, I might directly answer it, but when I see like an overwhelming amount of comments regarding a certain situation, I think it's a good idea to make a video. So, Series 5 is obviously coming soon. Now, this Friday seems like an ideal time for the Super Bowl promo drop, considering just the date of it and the time before the Super Bowl, but it could also be a good time for Series 5. I think we'll be getting something this Friday, for sure. Now, as far as Series 5 goes, Series 5, every new series update's always cool. I feel like we haven't got one in a while, right? If I recall correctly, our last one was like the beginning of December, like the first few days, which means we haven't gotten a series update in what feels like almost 2 months. More like, a month and a half, give or take. But first things first, guys, before we get into this video, make sure to go down below, hit that subscribe button, turn the notification bell, boys. We are 150 subscribers away from 18,000. It's a huge number, boys. Let's keep growing. You guys are new to the channel, come join. Always appreciate all the newcomers. Let's keep growing our community. Comment down below if you guys have any questions regarding Series 5, or if you guys are one of the commenters who influenced me to make this video, that'd be awesome. And make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Can we get this video to 300 likes? That'd be greatly appreciated. You guys have been going crazy with the likes. The channel's still recovering from the week off, but you guys have been going crazy, and I greatly appreciate that. I can definitely see that you guys come out here every day to show support, so thank you guys for that. Now let's get into this video. So first things first, coming over to the store. When it comes to series, something that we gotta worry about before anything else is going to be the competitive currency. Now, as you guys do know, the trophies do go over to a new trophy system, like the Series 5 set of trophies starting on the Series 5 update. Now, as you guys know, I'm very close to 1,000. So for all you guys who are very close to 1,000, you definitely wanna be using your series trophies before it ends, because you do lose half of them after a series update. So I really gotta get to this 1,000 to get my Coach Madden collectible before it happens, because if not, I'm gonna go back down to 400, which kind of defeats the purpose of all the trophies I've gained. It does kind of suck that they don't happen, that is what's gonna happen. So the Series 5 Master is gonna be another Master that comes out, as well as another John Madden collectible, more than likely. Now, the Series 4 Competitive Master was Brandon Cooks. At first, he seemed really great. At the end of the day, not many people ended up actually getting him. Now, for the next Master, it's probably gonna be like a 96 to 97 overall. It could be a 97, which would be really awesome. I have no idea what it could potentially be. I have no leads on that. As we know, we've gotten a outside linebacker, we've gotten a running back, we've gotten a wide receiver, and missing the other one. But we've gotten a few decent players. Now, do I think that the next one's gonna be great? Usually when the series first drops, they're one of the best cards in the game. So remember, if you guys do have a lot of trophies saved up, that could be a benefit for you guys as far as going ahead and being ready for that. Now, in my opinion, I think you want to get your John Madden collectibles. I think if you're almost at 1,000, you definitely don't get the half. Because I was thinking about it, it's either I get Madden collectible or I'm back at 400. And then it's really screwing me. I think I'm going to go with the John Madden collectible. I'm going to try to play some head-to-head seasons to get that done. And if you guys don't care for any of that, you have all this already, you could always just go ahead and do like the 89 pluses. You could always go ahead and do Wheel of Coins. You could do whatever you feel is going to get you the best return for your hard-earned trophies. Now, beyond that, the more important, well, that's important because that's like a time sensitive thing. You guys kind of got to do that before it happens, because if not, you're screwed. Now, more importantly, as far as what really excites us with this new series update, it's going to be the level up grind, potentially Gauntlet. Now, as you guys know, if we come over to Gauntlet, we got the Gauntlet upgrade, right? We got the Gauntlet 2, the Gauntlet 1. Now, there's supposed to be, I believe, one more Gauntlet. And typically, that's the third Gauntlet, which does give us access to another player. And then a Gauntlet Master, which we should have a set for. Now, the Gauntlet Master is usually around this time of the year. It's super cool. The Gauntlet Master, the way it works is when you get it all done. Let's see. No, they don't have it. So, it's Gauntlet 1, Gauntlet 2. Typically, there's like a Gauntlet 3. And then you can get a Gauntlet Master, like a 96, 95 overall player that you can pick. It's like a Gauntlet Legend, or it could be any of the ones you have, but a higher overall. And I believe they also start going into power-up sets after the final Gauntlet. So, it's going to be pretty awesome to finally get that done, as well as potentially a Journey. And remember, you guys want to be getting your Journey done, because Journey do have, at the end of the Journeys, there's a completion token. And I believe at some point, just like the Gauntlet Master completion token, they're going to be used for Gauntlet sets or Journey sets to get your Master players. So make sure you're getting that done. Now, next is going to be the level up grind, and the level up grind is huge. As you guys know, I love the level up grind, because for the most part, a level up grind does mean for me as a Madden player that I'm going to get close to 300k to half million coins during that time period. Typically, the level up grind introduces coin quick sells, like dollar packs that have platinum quick sells of like 150k, 88k, whatever. I usually end up with about a little over 500k per level up grind. Now, it's not always just because I make the coins from there or I get good pull. You can also get good pulls from the free packs they give you. But also it's because they give us power pass. Now our last power pass was a 95. So we're either gonna get a 96. I don't know. I think they might go solo from here on out, like 95, 96, 97, 98, 99. It's very possible. The best way to check is going to be going over to the daily progressions and seeing. Let's see, Mutt Dedication. Where's the daily engagement milestones? So is he going all the way down? 99, 98. Yeah, they're going one by one now. So the next one's probably gonna be a 96. Which is still pretty cool because there's plenty of Team of the Year cards. So you're probably going to get a free Team of the Year card minus the Aaron Donald and Russell Wilson. So that's really cool. As well as possibly some Super Bowl players. Although I think Super Bowl players, the best one's probably going to be more like 97 oriented. But we're going to be getting a new Power Pass. And that's one of the best ways to make coins for me. Because let's say I have let's say a 96, right? Casey Hayward, I believe, is 96 for that. Or George Kittle, 96. You buy George Kittle for 400K. You're rocking with him on your team. He's fully powered up. And now you get this Power Pass. Now you can go put him into the Power Pass. Upgrade the George Kittle with it, and then sell the Kittle you originally had. Now you made 400K back, plus the 300 plus to 400, 500K that you made from just leveling up, and all the new solos and everything, and then you end up with close to like 800K worth of value gained from that level up, as well as it gives you something to do. And now another important feature is typically with the level up grind is going to be the Torrey Holt upgradable tokens. Now Torrey Holt's a 97 overall. For me, that is chemmed up. I believe he might be stock 96. So stock 96, it means his next upgrades are going to become available to us pretty soon, I believe. Now, we usually get two of them. So he's probably going to get to a 98 overall in the next series update, which also means that he's probably going to be a 99 chemmed up. So he's probably going to have close to 99 route running. He's going to have close to 99 catching. And he's probably on my team going to have like a 90, I'd say like a 97 speed. So he's going to be one of the best wide receivers in Madden. He's going to be like what Antonio Brown cards used to be. Super quick, super fast, with great, great route running, with pretty good catching. That's probably going to be like an Antonio Brown base card, which is going to be pretty cool. And then as well as, guys, I believe we should be getting a Pat Tillman upgrade at some point. As you guys know, we haven't gotten a Pat Tillman upgrade since like the initial set of Pat Tillman tokens from the beginning of the year. So there should be a fair amount of stuff ready for Pat Tillman. Now, the next Pat Tillman upgrade, which I believe we should be getting, I don't know if it'll be with the series update or how they're going to do it, but this Pat Tillman is going to have like a 95 speed, 96 speed, probably going to get to a 99 overall. He's going to have like a 97 hit power, 95 zone, 99 tackle, 99 player, 99 pursuit, and the man's probably going to hit into the 80s. Going to be one of the best strong safeties in the game, probably at the time being the best strong safety in the game. We're really just waiting for the Pat Tillman to be upgraded to Torrey Holt. Once they're upgraded, they're going to be end game cards. And then if you want to be really budgety, you can rock with them the rest of the year, which I'm probably going to do because I don't think it makes sense to buy a card in a position that I already have a card that plays similar. Like Torrey Holt balls out for me. The only issue with Torrey Holt occasionally has been his catch traffic. I've felt that. But this next card should definitely make you, well, the next upgrade should definitely get rid of that issue. So as a whole, guys, we have the Series Master. We got the Torrey Holt upgrades, Pat Tillman upgrades. We get the level up grind. We got the power passes. We got gauntlet completion. We got journey completion. I don't know if the journey will be completed or the gauntlet. I know we will be getting the third set of gauntlet more than likely. But will that mean it's completed? I'm not entirely sure. What if they make the next series the actual set? I'm not entirely sure. And we got new trophies. So don't forget about the new trophies. Which also could, maybe we'll be starting getting like increased weekend league rewards or headset season rewards. I don't know if they actually do that, but they should definitely look into something like that. Because we're getting later in the year. The rewards definitely need to be increased the slightest bit. Because unless you're placed in like top 50 in the world, you're not getting the greatest rewards. Pack odds also typically increase, guys. Don't forget about that. Pack odds do increase, which is good because series to series, they're like, okay. That's why they end, at the end of each series, opening packs kind of sucks because the packs can still pull such bad cards. As you get into the next series, it's kind of usually the best time to open packs as the odds have just recently increased. We're also getting new series Redux cards, guys, just letting you guys know. So if you guys know any limited time cards that have come out recently that you haven't been able to afford, they're going to be series Reduxes. Now, guys like the signature series that come out today, like the Derrick Henry, he probably won't, if it does come out on Friday, he won't probably be a part of the chain of Redux cards because he came out too close to the end. But let's see, what are some LTDs that have recently come out? So like this Joe Runyon has a potential chance to be a series Redux card, which means it would be highly affordable. There hasn't been too many 96, 97s, it's more 94, 95s. So if you guys have any 94, 95s you've been wanting that have been LTD, you will be able to probably afford them going into the Series 5 update. Now, I'm not entirely sure which ones are LTD. I haven't really looked through all of them. I kind of lose track because now there's so many great cards. The LTDs kind of get lost within them. Buda Baker, I'm assuming, is one of them here. Khalil Mack will be a Redux, which is really awesome. Yeah, that means it's going to be quite affordable going into this, which is cool. So will Richard Sherman. most of the Zero Chill LTDs, as well as some of the coming into like the playoff promo, anything like that will be in this, and Legends, more than likely. It's gonna be Legends and Zero Chill cards, which is gonna make up the bulk of it. But guys, that is about it for this video. I think I did cover everything I want to talk about. This is pretty much what we want to do, how to prepare, kind of like a culmination of everything that's coming out of Series 5, and what I'd recommend doing. Like I said, my recommendations as far as trophies go, you want to spend them. I took the half last, unless you have like 3,000 of them and you want to get the master real quick. It's fair, you could do that, that's fine. But other than that, I'm gonna use mine because I did get screwed last time not using them, and now I ended up at like the same spot again. So I'll probably end up using them. As far as the solos you want to be playing your journey and gauntlet, maxing them all out, getting your completion tokens done, because if they do end up using those as the final masterpiece for the next set of gauntlets or journeys, if it isn't gonna be the next one, you will have them done already instead of having to play a shit ton of solos when they do end up dropping. And then the level of grind, just get your level up to where it should be already, get it to max, play the solo, so that nothing's worse than the new level of grind coming out and then you're like 30 behind and now it's just way too much. I like to always be at the max, and then I can just knock out the 10 real quick and I'm back to normal. But guys, that's about it for the video. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new to the channel, make sure to go down below, hit that subscribe button, turn the noti bell, boys, come join the family. I greatly appreciate it. Let's get to 18,000 by today. Make sure to comment down below if you need any help or any other questions, and make sure to make sure to like. If we can get to 300 likes in this video, that'd be awesome. Thank you guys for all the support. Let's keep it up. I'm out. Peace.